We have a great show for you today. We have some folks from Long Island. We have Ron Aprea. He's a saxophonist, composer, arranger, and he's also here with his son. And he's a violinist, a professional violinist. And so we're going to open up the show with a performance by them. And then a little bit later, they're going to come over into the hot seats next to me, and we're going to find out a little bit more about them. So if the control room can roll in the music, that would be really great. And we're going to head over to Ron and Matt and open up with the show with the music. So take it away. Thank you.
Last time we were here was about a year ago.
Yes, right? Welcome back.
And these two tunes that we just played were a dream at that point. We we played both of these tunes with a small group, piano, bass, and drums. And after doing your show, I thought, wow, you know what? Since I worked with Lennon, I guess we'll talk about that, back in 1974, I thought, I've been thinking for years about doing a Lennon tribute. Uh-huh. And after doing your show, it kind of inspired me to sit down and go to work.
Yes, you had about 75,000 hits on your press release in just a week's time.
Yes, so I thought, maybe it's an idea to seems like it might be a good time to do it. So.
And we all love the music. We never get tired of it. And to hear this rearrangement of it was so wonderful.
Yeah, we kind of jazzed him up a little bit.
Yeah.
Stated his melodies and did our little variations and our little, counter themes and stuff.
Mm-hmm. And you brought Matt in on the violin. That was really sweet. Congratulations on learning that instrument. I tried taking lessons for 2 years and I was still pretty squeaky. But I really love listening to it. What is it like to perform with your dad?
It's a great experience, and recording on the album was also a great time too. We had a full string quartet, so it was a great opportunity to really have some fun with the quartet.
Good for you, yeah. And were you involved with any of the arrangement, or was that all you, Ron, with?
Well, I did the arranging, and Matt contracted the string section.
Okay.
And since it's a jazz album, we had to be careful who the who the string plays. Well, we tried to get string plays that were, you know, sensitive to the interpretation of jazz, and mm-hmm. And they came in and they sounded great. They nailed it, you know.
And it's been a process for you during the year. You did a Kickstarter program that was very successful.
Yes. Yeah, that was interesting. I was a little worried about that. You know, people are just going to, why would they want to give me money? But we put a video clip together and we put it up on Kickstarter. Uh-huh. And it explained, you know, what I was trying to do and what my affiliation was with Lennon. Uh-huh. Amazingly, the donations and the support was amazing. Mm-hmm. You know, so it worked out real well. We reached our goal. You know, Kickstarter. If you don't,
you surpassed the goal.
Yeah.
Yes.
But if you don't, it's like all or nothing.
Yeah.
If you don't make your goal,
that's pretty stressful.
It's like zip. Everybody gets their donations back,
yeah.
And whatever. So it's a little stressful, but I was so happy. I can't tell you the joy that I had seeing all these people, you know, kicking into my idea.
Uh-huh.
You know, 'cause it was just an idea basically at that point.
Yeah.
You know?
Was it a lot of work to rearrange so many of his songs?
Yeah, I spent a lot of time. When we left here last year, I went to work. I have every tune that Lennon and McCartney, old Beatles tunes, I have two volumes of everything they wrote. And it took me probably a month and a half just to go through all that material and see which ones would work with what I'm trying to do.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
You know, and then of course that next phase is arranging, writing all the arrangements. Then we had a rehearsal with the strings up at Matt's apartment. And so we started putting it together piece by piece. And it's done, and I've been fortunate for this time around. Of course, we had a little budget, so I was able to do things that mm-hmm. that normally I wouldn't be able to do. And I have some of the world-class jazz players on this album, Brian Lynch on trumpet, mm-hmm. Cecilia Coleman on piano, and Don Manassi, legendary guitar player. He's featured, and we even brought in Steve Madeo mm-hmm. from Palm Springs. Now, Steve Madeo, for the people that don't know who Steve is, Steve hired me to play with Lennon in 1974 on Walls and Bridges album.
How many years is that? My goodness.
That's 40 years ago. And Steve is still around. In fact, he's on tour now. He's in Europe right now. But Steve was a good buddy of mine. We had been playing in a lot of bands together, mm-hmm. Jazz bands and local bands and whatever around New York. And Steve called me one night, and like he always did, he would call me 2-3 times a week.
Mm-hmm.
He still does. We talk all the time.
That's wonderful.
We chat. Mm-hmm. And he says, what are you doing tomorrow? And I said, nothing. I said, what's going on? He said, I got a recording project you might want to do. I said, good, all right. And then we just went on. We small talked for another 20 minutes. So before we hung up, I said to Steve, oh, by the way, I said, tell me about the recording project. He says, oh, he says, it's at the record plant with John Lennon.
<That's>
and like
serious.
He just drops the bomb.
You know? Did you sleep that night? I mean, come on. Yeah.
Well, yeah, I was maybe more concerned about the genre of the music than I was about meeting John Lennon.
Uh-huh.
You know, not being familiar with, I was touring with jazz bands.
Mm-hmm.
I had just come off the road with Lionel Hampton's band and did a little work with Woody Herman's band and mostly big band things and some small groups as well, but in the jazz genre.
Mm-hmm.
So I was a little more worried about the interpretation of the music than I was about meeting mm-hmm. John. But it's always nice to work with people that you see in the movies and the people that are, you know, recognizable, you know, mm-hmm. personalities. So it's always fun working with pros and could be. And so it was a ball. I love every minute of doing the album. You know, John was such a sweetheart, easy guy to work with, you know.
And last time you were here, you had a frame. Can you tell us about the
sure.
photostat?
Yeah, the photostat. If anybody wants to see it, they can go to my website, ronaprea.com, and just click John Lennon, and there's the whole story on my website and photos, some pictures from the session, and a photostat of John's face. we didn't really have music other than John's lead sheets. We didn't have formal arrangements. You know, most of the stuff we did was what we called head arrangements, making them up as we were going. So I was making copies of John's lead sheets in one of the other rooms up at Record Plant, and he comes walking in, and you know, John was always kind of like a kind of a fun guy. He was a practical joker kind of guy. And he comes walking in and sticks his face in the photostat machine and hits the button. And two blinding lights later, these photostats come sliding out with his nose a little flat, you know, and his glasses.
You can see his glasses and his teeth, you know?
And again, I was so preoccupied with the music, I didn't even realize the significance of what he had just done. And basically, he hands one to me, hands one to Steve. Steve's is gone, by the way. I spoke with Steve recently, and I don't know what happened. His stuck to the frame or something, and his got ruined. Mm-hmm. So I think mine is the only one left. Mm-hmm. But that's basically the story with the photostat. And I made a copy, and I
have one.
I autographed it and gave it to you last time I was here.
Yes, I have it hanging in my apartment.
it's a classic.
Yeah, that's really great.
Yeah.
And how has your father influenced you to become a professional musician?
Well, just growing up, I've been surrounded by music all the time. Mm-hmm. I mean, I grew up around jazz, and then I eventually decided to get into classical more. Mm. But it was a great environment to be around.
Have you ever been on television before?
I actually have been.
Have
I
you?
Was on a show called The Chew.
Oh, right.
On ABC. Yeah.
It was a Valentine's Day they came in and...
Yeah, it was a Valentine's Day special, and they wanted a strolling violinist. So I strolled for the couple that was eating.
That's fun. Yeah, I love television. It's a lot of hassle, right? But it's a lot of fun.
And we still have that in our DVR. Trying to figure out how to get it onto a disc.
That's great. Anyway. That's great. Well, thanks for coming in. So what do you do to keep yourself busy? Go ahead. I'm sorry.
Sure.
I was about to interrupt you. It's like you recently at Joe's Pub.
Oh, yeah, that's right. Yeah. It was a show with jazz drummer Brian Carter.
Yeah. Do you know that his dad's, what is it, Ron Carter?
Ron Carter.
I found that out from you, actually. it was a really fun show.
Oh, I really enjoyed it. Yeah. I'm glad I was able to get to it. Your dad posted it on Facebook, and I saw it, and...
That was a fun night.
Yeah, I really enjoyed it.
We hung out and caught a really good show. The band was excellent.
Wonderful.
And all the singers, they had three singers. Mm-hmm. Every one was amazing.
What is that, four strings, two, or two, mm-hmm. right?
A string quartet.
Yes, wonderful. And a sax guy, I think it was. The drummer was wonderful.
Yeah, it was actually two horns, trumpet. I don't remember their
wonderful
names.
Wonderful show.
Younger guys that I'm not familiar with, but wonderful players.
Wonderful. Yeah, it was
great. I mean, Ron Carter Jr.
Come on.
He's not gonna hire bad players. His father might have something to say about that.
Right? Yeah. That was really amazing to me. I'm a kind of a drummer groupie, and so when I was watching him, I was like, wow, this guy's doing everything. Orchestrating and singing and drumming, and had just a great jazz band. I really enjoyed it. It got me into the Christmas spirit.
Yeah. Yeah.
And you had a Christmas song today that you were performing.
Yes, actually, it's a Christmas song, but it's kind of a tune that in my mind, it works anytime. You know, it's a war's over is really what the tune is about.
Yeah, happy Christmas.
So, and it's such a great tune. It's such a fun tune to play on. I thought I would kind of treat it a little bit different. Like we opened with the violin, you know,
beautiful,
stating melody very prettily with the with the other strings behind them, and then of course I played a melody for one chorus, and then we do what we call a variation of the theme, and we did that little scat together with the violin and
that was fun.
And the alto, and it's based on his chords, you know. And then of course I went into the solo. It's just you know, it's got that 6/8 kind of a motion to it that I like, you know.
And you Imagine was the other song that you
Imagine
played.
Was the other one.
Yeah. That's one of the, I think, world's favorite. I mean, you know, when is the CD coming out?
Because the CD's going to be out in March.
In March? March 18th is my birthday. That would be a great release date.
Is that your birthday?
Yeah, and then it'll be
Pisces. Well, then that's the date.
Oh, right.
That's it. It's official. But let me just say something about Imagine. Of course, Matt and I just played it. On the album, Steve Madeo, the fellow we were just talking about, who hired me, to play with John Lennon in 1974. He lives in Palm Springs now, but we were able to get him to New York to play on that track. So when you hear the album, you'll hear Steve and I playing like a little duet, on Imagine. I thought that was really appropriate, to get Steve back. You know, there were five horns on that, so Steve and I are almost 50% of the little big horns, which was what Lennon called us for the album.
I think it's great that you know people for such a long period of time, like, our whole lives, and I like to hang on to my friends as long as I can or as possible,
Yeah, you have to be careful when you friend me because I never let you go.
Right, we chat a lot. I don't know if we're Facebook friends yet, but...
I don't think so.
Yeah, maybe I sent a friend's request. You got to check that.
Okay.
So what do you do outside of, in your normal kind of a day?
Well, I freelance mostly, and then I also teach.
Oh, do you?
Yes, I teach violin and piano.
Oh, wonderful.
And viola.
Oh, viola, really? Is it as a private teacher, or do you work?
As a private teacher.
Good for you. Mm-hmm. We just recently had a children's program where we had a voice teacher come in with a lot of her students.
Oh, great.
Yeah, it was very challenging. we had a lot of sound issues, but it was a lot of fun. Yeah, so maybe you can bring your students in, too.
All right.
Yeah, we'll work on that after the show.
And I just want to add that he's expanded that a little bit. He's got his own music school now, his online music school.
That's right. Tell us about that.
It's called the New York Virtual Conservatory.
Uh-huh.
And it's an online teaching school where anyone really around the world, intermediate to advanced, can take lessons with a professional that's based in New York.
Wow, that's great. So maybe I should bring out my violin again. I'm still a beginner, though. Maybe you'll do special.
Oh, just some private lessons.
Yeah, <that's it. laughs> there goes my savings, right? Yeah, I keep trying. We're about down to our last minute and a half. Is there anything else you want to talk about? Give a shout to your wife, Angela.
Yeah, Angela.
Angela, where are you?
Feel better, honey.
Yeah, I was hoping to bring her in on the show. It isn't often that I get to have family members together, so.
Well, Angela and I, actually, we do a lot of work together. We'll be at, by the way, we should mention this, we'll be at Trumpets with the big band. I have a 16-piece big band with some of the world's finest musicians, New York's and New Jersey's best. And we've been there for almost a year now. And we do the last Sunday of every month. So we'll be there, whatever the date is. I don't even know what the date is. Whatever the last Sunday is of this month, we'll be there with the 16-piece band. Trumpets is in Montclair, New Jersey, and it's a great, great room for listening. Uh-huh. It's got a beautiful stage with a grand piano. It's got a nice PA system, nice lighting, and there's no bad seats. It reminds me of, we were talking about this before, it reminds me of a small Birdland, or smaller Birdland. It's not a small club at all, but it's a little smaller than Birdland. It's set up pretty much the same way with tables all around the stage.
Beautiful.
Yeah.
Wonderful. And how do people find you?
My website, I guess, www.ronaprea.com.
And how about you, Matt?
It's mattaprea.com.
Okay, very good. Well, that's about it for the show today. Thank you so much for coming in. We're here every Friday afternoon at 2 p.m., and we will see you next week.